The ocean, vast, beautiful, powerful. It's easy to see why many researchers try to tap into our planet's biggest powerhouse. One group of researchers are working on a way to take full advantage of the ocean's seemingly endless depths by harnessing the power of buoyancy. So how exactly does buoyancy work? And how could you use it to store energy? Could this technology hold the key to helping level out renewable energy generation like wind and solar? Or is it yet another grid energy pipe dream bound to sink to the depths? We thought these questions deserve a deeper dive today on Two Bit da Vinci. Special thanks to Air+Health for sponsoring the show. And this, the SKYE, what I'd call the Tesla of air purifiers. More on this in just a little bit. Let's go out on a nice, relaxing sailing adventure. Ah, isn't that nice? Just a smooth, relaxing ride on top of the ocean. But wait a minute, why doesn't our heavy boat sink straight down? The answer is buoyancy. Buoyancy is an upward force exerted by a fluid on an object immersed in that fluid in a gravity field. Because our boat is filled with air, it's less dense than the water it displaces. Therefore, it floats even though it's super heavy. In fluids, pressure increases with depth, creating a net upward force called the buoyancy force, which fights against the gravity and is equivalent to the weight of the fluid of the object displaced. So why does this happen? Imagine a virtual cylinder rising up into space. In space, you have no pressure, but the closer to the surface you are, the more air molecules you have pressing down on you. Air and water are both fluids, so our virtual cylinder can extend down into the ocean, and the deeper you dive, the more water molecules you have above you pushing down. And so when anything is submerged in water, the pressure at the lowest point is higher than at the highest point, and that net difference causes buoyancy. It's this buoyancy force that researcher Julian Hunt and a team of global scientists have harnessed in their Buoyant Energy Storage Technology, or BEST. But does it really live up to this acronym? You know what really floats our boat? Hit that like button. Buoyant energy storage builds off similar principles as pumped hydropower storage, but with a few key differences. Traditional hydropower stores potential energy in water contained in an upper reservoir, which is then released downward using gravity to convert potential energy into kinetic energy, turning a turbine and creating electricity. BES technology stores potential energy but uses buoyancy. Instead of an upper and lower reservoir, BEST has an outer reservoir, any large body of water, a lake, a tank, or in the case of BEST, the ocean, and a floating inner reservoir. As the inner reservoir submerges, it stores potential energy. How does this work? Imagine you're in a swimming pool. In your hands, you got a beach ball, and you slowly lower it under the water. Because the ball is full of air, which is less dense than water, it takes a significant amount of energy to submerge the ball. Holding the ball underwater would store all that power as potential energy as the buoyancy force builds. This is essentially how the BES technology works. Instead of beach balls, a large platform anchored to the ocean floor connects to an enormous square, 100 meters per side, made up of high-density polyethylene pipes full of compressed gas like air or hydrogen. Powerful electric motors pull those buoyant tubes downward, storing the potential energy in the buoyant mass, just like our beach ball. So once the energy is stored, how do we get it out of the ocean and into our smartphones? By releasing the platform, the immense buoyancy pushes the platform upward, pulling the electric motor in reverse, turning a generator, and sending all that power back into the grid. This technology comes with a number of advantages over other energy storage. Where BEST could have one major advantage over pumped hydro is efficiency. Buoyancy energy storage's architectural simplicity means minimal energy loss during the energy production. And the constant pressure head allows the pumps and turbines to operate at high levels of efficiency at all given times. Buoyancy energy could reach levels of between 85 and 95% efficient, compared to conventional pumped storage systems, which sit somewhere between 75 and 80%. We've covered pumped hydro storage in our video all about mechanical energy storage, which you can check out here. BES systems could also pair with hydrogen storage and transportation. Shoot, but I might not have even known if it wasn't for our sponsor this week, SKYE by Air+Health. Why do I call it the Tesla of air purifiers? Easy, it's really smart. And I have it set up to alert me if the air quality ever drops, and it automatically ramps up the fans. At slow speeds, it's whisper quiet, and on high, it can clear up to 1,200 square feet and move an impressive 420 CFM. The SKYE has a 5-stage air purification system. 1, the pre-filter captures larger particles. 2, the HEPA filter captures 99.97% of particles down to 0.3 microns. 3, the carbon filter removes odors in the air. 4, AirHealth's patented ProCell photocatalytic oxidation layer helps to break down organic compounds like harmful gases and chemicals. And lastly, a powerful UVC light to reduce viruses and bacteria. In a third-party lab test against the COVID-19 virus, SKYE reduced pathogens by 99.9% in less than 30 minutes. Start improving your indoor air quality today with the AirHealth SKYE. Link and special 10% discount code in the video description. If you've seen our video on the solid-state hydrogen batteries, you know one of the major challenges in the hydrogen energy game is compressing and transporting hydrogen. BESS systems already use the hydrogen in their platform materials, which gets compressed as it's submerged. It could then be transported via large underwater pipes, a process that could reduce the cost of hydrogen storage by a factor of 30 compared to conventional compressors. Another untold benefit of buoyancy energy storage is in safety for marine wildlife. While the buoyancy tubes do move compared to other technologies like tidal turbines, they are vastly safer. We should probably also remember that the best technology requires no exotic materials and isn't beholden to complex supply chains. You guys probably know how much I love this because it allows us to reserve more of the exotic materials like lithium and nickel for more energy-dense applications like cars and possibly planes. While the technology may not be as feasible in every context, not every part of the world has access to deep reservoirs of water, it has major global potential around oceanic islands and coastlines. It could even be paired with offshore wind turbines and ocean current power stations. So there are some pretty interesting benefits to this technology, but what about cost? The cost of grid storage for lithium-ion batteries is around $150 per kilowatt hour, though those prices are expected to drop in the coming years. BEST would be somewhere between $50 and $100 per kilowatt hour. Not bad. But things aren't quite that cut and dry. While it's easy and economic to store energy, releasing that energy is much more challenging. Remember that there are electric motors and cables, all of which are underwater. Due to a host of challenges, power output from these systems comes at a much higher price. Compared to other methods, BESS systems are a question of energy capacity versus power capacity. Using water as an analogy, energy capacity is the size of the tank you have to fill, and the power capacity is the size of the hose that you have to either fill or empty that tank. If you have an energy capacity of 1 kilowatt hour in your system and a power capacity of 1 kilowatt, you could output 1 kilowatt of power for 1 hour before you'd be out of energy. BESS systems are not a great solution if you need huge amounts of power in short periods of time, like in a power outage, or in England when a majority of Brits all turn on their electric kettles after watching their favorite television program, all at the same time. In this sort of situation, we'll need another answer. But if you could instead think about charging and discharging the system over longer periods of time, let's say weeks, not days, hours, or milliseconds, then this thing might just be an interesting breakthrough for the future. Installation costs are also a factor. BEST has an installed power capacity from $4,000 to $8,000 per kilowatt. For comparison, a wind turbine comes in at an installed power capacity of about $1,600 per kilowatt. And lithium-ion batteries are still king, coming in around $1,000 per kilowatt. So in some instances, BEST is not always best. BEST-owned researchers recognize that their systems would likely never replace batteries altogether, but could function in a system that utilizes the strengths of both technologies. Switching gears to talk about efficiency, we have to address the choices of compression gas. The following graph shows what happens to the density of air and hydrogen as a function of depth in meters. Hydrogen has a much lower density to start, that even at 6,000 meters, its density only increases to 50 kilograms per meter cubed. Compare this to air, which increases to a density of 528 kilograms per meter cubed at 6,000 meters. This is why hydrogen is so important. At 6,000 meters, water's density is 1,028 kilograms per meter cubed. And when the change in density decreases, so does the force of buoyancy. If these buoyancy tubes aren't rigid members, the increase in exterior pressure will also cause a drop in volume, again, reducing the energy storing capacity. These are the sorts of engineering challenges best researchers have to optimize for. Based on these graphs showing changes in density and volume, researchers have found that the best possible system works in a range between 3,000 meters and 10,000 meters. 10,000 meters is about 30,000 feet. There are not many places in the ocean that deep, but that would be the ideal use case. The proposed best system with hydrogen as a compressed gas, generating electricity from a depth of 10,000 meters to 3,000 meters and an efficiency of about 90%, can store 7.9 gigawatt hours of electricity. The challenges are plenty, to be sure. Motors, electrical equipment, and salt water, for example. There are also questions about the impact on marine habitats, system reliability, and how much maintenance would be required. Overall, using this technology in conjunction with other production and storage technology could create a much more flexible and versatile means of leveling out grid energy. But what do you think? Is BEST really the best way to store energy for the grid going forward? Can you think of any other places buoyancy energy storage could be applied? Sound off in the comments below. All right, so this is another one of those really interesting, quirky approaches to energy storage. It has its benefits, of course. It doesn't need lithium or nickel or cobalt or anything else, but it's also really challenging and complicated. We're talking about really, really deep parts of our ocean, the labor and installation cost. But as I mentioned, you can store a pretty good amount of energy. Just remember that the energy storage is great, but the power density is very low. So this would have to be one of those more low-level grid baseline production methods. But pretty cool stuff, right? Thank you to all of you for watching. And if you want to be a rockstar supporter of the show, consider joining the 2Bit tribe, our YouTube channel members, and our patrons on Patreon. Come join us on Discord, chat about future videos, come travel with us, sound off on future topics we might cover, all for just a small membership fee each month. And there's no long-term commitments. Also, check out the channel. There's some other videos that we think you're going to like. And if nothing else, just remember that the future is going to be awesome.